All right. Here we are again. We're still word embeddings, so how to represent a word in a vector space. We've seen C-ball skip gram, but we've seen when we derive the update rule that this is a very expensive solution. Yeah? And this is related to the facts that we have a softmax here. And then every time we update, we need to run the softmax for all the words in the vocabulary. We've seen then a solution on how to do negative sampling and solve that issue. In this case, we drop the softmax nonlinearity and we replace it by a sigmoid. So instead of 7,500 softmax operations, you train 7,500 binary classifiers. And in order to reduce, we do negative sampling. So instead of going through all the negative examples, we just pick a few. Yeah. Another method that we're gonna see now is hierarchical softmax. So here we keep the softmax character of the activation function. But our vocabulary needs to be organized in a binary tree. What is a binary tree? Well, at the leaves of the tree, you find the words of your vocabulary, and you keep splitting up to the fact you have two leaves for a note. Yeah? So I did that already. Huh? So let's take the example we always use, the cat jumped over the fence and ran away. If we do skip gram, the center word jumped is given. We try to predict the context word, in this case, cat. Yeah. This binary tree we also call a Huffman tree. And words that are more rare, you will find deeper in the tree. Yeah. Common words will be higher in the tree. The vocabulary in this case is 8. We have 8 different words. So, and then we have 8 leaves. Here they are. Fence, jump, the way, ran, overcat, and D. Yeah? So, what we're gonna do first is we're gonna number the internal nodes. Yeah? What is an internal node? Well, these are nodes that do not touch the leaves. So in our case we have 6. Yeah. So this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, and this is 6. Yeah. So we have 6 internal nodes. Yeah. Now we have 7. Because we go from 0 to 6, yeah? So the number of internal nodes, equals the vocabulary minus 1. Now we've seen that when we discussed decision trees. All right, so now how does it work? First we're gonna train the tree. And how will we do this? Well, we have an output matrix. And here we have 4, 5, 6 internal nodes. Right? And jumped is the word that is given. Now we want to see how we get to cat. Right? So you take the word jumped. Yeah, and now we see how we get to cat, and we start with the top node. So basically what we're gonna do is take the word vector of jumped, take the dot product, then apply the activation value, can be a sigmoid in this case, gives us a value between 0 and 1. Yeah, And then you have the Z value. And the Z value is Z is 1, Z is 0. When you go to the left, to the right, Z is 1. And to the left, when Z is 0. Alright, so in this case, in order to get to cat, we go to the right. So this is a 0, sorry, I will use another color. So this is a 1 here, this is a 0. So for Z, we have a 1, okay? So once we're here in node 4, yeah, we take the dot product again, and in this case, we go left. So this is 0, this is 1. Yeah, so we go to node 4, we do exactly the same. It's a value between 0 and 1. And here we go to the left, so that's a 0. Alright? Then we're in node 3, and here we're gonna go to the right again. This is 1, this is 1, this is 0. So we're gonna go to node 3, the output will be 1. So again, we will do a dot product, yeah? And we'll end up with a value between 0 and 1. So here, as I have my output, I will have a percentage of ones, and I will have a percentage of zeros, yeah? So if I start on the top here, I could assume that 28 out of 100, assume we have 100 words, are gonna go to the right, and 62 out of 100 words are gonna go to the left. Okay? So that is basically how we build a tree, and then we're gonna train the model in such a way that the system learns to navigate the tree to get to the right context word. Now this is all great, but how do we get, so then we have step 3, how do we get probabilities? Right? And here already gave an indication on probabilities. For example, going to the right in this case is 0.28. Going to the left is 0.72. Yeah, it's not 62. It's 72. All right. So, for example, assume that we want to predict the word ran given away. Yeah. So it's here ran given is your center word, and ran is your context word, and you want to calculate this probability. Well, in order to do so, we do exactly the same. Yeah, so we try to find out how to get to away, and away is all the way down here. Yeah, so let us assume, let's give another few probabilities that this is 0.2 and this is 0.8. And then we go down here, is 0.1, 0.9. Yeah, and then we have these two here, is 0.9, 0.1. Okay, these are all numbers that we get from training the tree. And now if we want to calculate the probability of ran given away, well, basically we have the same, So we have our matrix 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, and then here we have your activation value. And our word given is away. That's our given word. So again, we start from 6, take the dot product, and calculate the activation value. So in this case will be 0.28. Then we're here, and here I gotta go right again. So I take this value, 0.2 in node 4. Yeah, once I'm here, I gotta go to the right again, so it's 0.1, and this is node 2, 0.1. And when I'm in node 0, I gotta go to the left, and it's 0.1. Yeah, so I take 4, 2, 0, and again it's 0.1. Okay? Because here I need to go to the left, because this is my word away. So, if I multiply all these, then I get the probability of RAN given away. Yeah? So let us do the quick calculation here. Calculation is 0.1 times 0.1 times 0.2 times 0.28. This is a very low probability. Yeah. Obviously, it's a bit counterintuitive because they appear together here, but this is because I took arbitrary numbers in terms of these probabilities weights. Yeah. I assume if you do the true exercise that your probability is basically gonna be higher than what you get, because here what you get is 0.5%. Yeah. Which I 0.05%. Yeah, 0.05%. I assume in reality it will be higher. But I just wanted to show you how this hierarchical softmax works.